Watch this before you buy a gas water heater, because I'm going to give you one big tip to help you save money on your choice of water heaters. So if you're buying a water heater, chances are yours is either broke, ruptured, flooded, or something, or you're just thinking it's time before any of that happens. Good for you. Here's what I'm going to recommend to you is the plumber that comes out, if you call a plumber to come out to buy a water heater from, chances are he's going to try to sell you a tankless water heater. Don't get me wrong. I don't have anything against tankless water heaters. I just want you to think about the ROI, return on investment. How much are you going to have to invest in order to go from a tank type water heater to a tankless? A retrofit like that can be done. Retrofits happen all the time. We do them. But there's a lot of things that I want you to think about before you do it, because you may not be aware of what all can happen. The first thing is the gas load calculation chart. A plumber really needs to come out, measure your current gas system, look at every gas fixture that you have, check the BTUs on it, draw it up, and verify that you can add the extra gas that a tankless water heater is going to require. Why is that important? Your current gas water heater takes 40 to 50,000 BTUs on the average. A tankless water heater takes almost 200,000. That's a big difference. That's 160,000 BTUs extra. That's like having five of those tank top water heaters sitting there firing all at the same time every time that tankless fires. If you're not aware of that up front, what can happen? What if you've got your log lighter turned on and your tankless kicks on and it draws all this gas? You could actually lose the flame to your fireplace because all that gas is being drawn to the tankless. When that happens, when the tankless quits, now you've just got gas going in the fireplace. And if there's not a flame there, that's just gas coming into your house. That's why that is so important. So whenever I talk about the additional installation costs for a tankless water heater, the gas load calculation chart is going to take a plumber, I'm going to say about an hour to get out here, draw up, calculate, spend the time to get everything done just to find out if your current gas system can handle it. Now, if it can't, now they're looking at either running a new relay from the meter to your house, or maybe even increasing the size from the where it comes into your house all the way through it. There's a lot of things to look at. Now, there's other options there. The plumber could come in and put regulators on all the fixtures and just increase the pressure. So there's different ways to go, but either way, that's an additional cost to convert from your tank style water heater to your tankless. Now, an additional cost is the reconfiguration of the piping. You've got two pipes that come out up high for a tank top water heater. On a tankless, they go down below. So those pipes are going to have to be reran and altered and changed and done different things with. You've also got to add flush valves to the bottom of the tankless water heater. That way you can flush it annually, which leads me to maintenance work that has to be done every year. Most tankless manufacturers require that a licensed professional come out and flush the water heater annually. This keeps the lime buildup out, all the scale on the inside, and what that does is it makes your tankless water heater more efficient and it makes it last longer. That way you're not damaging that heat exchanger on the inside of the tankless water heater. Another thing is these new tankless water heaters, they're condensating. So you've got to have a condensation drain. To have a drain, you've got to have a place to drain it to. And it's got to be done right. That way it's not just tied into the sewer system. There has to be an air gap or there has to be a P-trap. Where you tie it in really depends on how the house is configured and where the tankless water heater is going. Are you putting it up in an attic or are you trying to put it in the same closet that the other tank top is already in? So think about it. It may depend on where you're putting it as to if you can do it or not. And let's say you are putting it up in an attic. If you've currently got a tank top water heater, now you're going tankless. Now you have to build a support system. You have to build a wall. You have to build something to attach this to. Tankless water heaters don't just stand on the ground like the tank top do. So you've got to build a frame or a stand to actually secure it to. It's going to hold this water heater and support it so you don't have any problems. You don't want that done poorly either. It needs to be done right and it needs to be solid enough to hold this water heater where you never have a problem with it. If you're also putting this tankless water heater up in the attic now, is there an electrical outlet there? Because your tank top water heater probably doesn't have one. It may have electricity to it for a pump or something like that, so it's a possibility. Chances are, if it's just a regular water heater, a gas water heater up in the attic requires no electricity. So you may be running an additional electrical line just to have a spot to plug the tankless water heater into. Now, a tankless water heater also has a different vent type system. It's not just your normal type B gas vent. It can be PVC on some types or stainless steel on some types. But either way, that's an additional cost and additional expense that you're going to have to invest in the very beginning in order to go to a tankless system. Now, one of the last things that you need to think about too, whenever we're talking about ROI, is the maintenance of it. Remember, I told you, you're going to have to flush this system every year. So think about that. What's it going to cost? Because you need to add that into the expense of your water heater. And the other thing is, if you read the manufacturer's recommendations, it normally says the water coming in must be treated. Whether it's a water filtration system, an anti-scale system, a water softener, whatever it is, think about it, because that is something too you may have to install just to make sure that you have a warranty on your tankless water heater. Now let's talk about a few bad things about the tankless, and then I'll get to the point as to how to really save money. A tankless water heater, if you're not aware of it, you can get a cold water sandwich, and they're not fun. But what that is say I'm taking a shower, I turn off the water and then turn it back on for some reason. Maybe I forgot to rinse my hair. You know, I have a lot of it. But if I forgot to rinse my hair and I turn off the water heater and then I turn it back on, I need to remember that when I turned off the hot water, it shut off the water heater. So it allowed cold water to go through it. And then when I turned the water back on, it started heating it up again. My shower valve, even though I've got it set to hot, doesn't realize that cold water's coming through that line. What's going to happen is I'm going to have a nice hot shower, and then all of a sudden it's going to be really cold, and then it's going to go back to hot. So cold water sandwiches like that, they happen. Don't get me wrong, it's not going to kill you, but if you're not ready for it, it will surprise you very, very quickly. Again, remember the water treatment that I talked about. Check your manufacturer's recommendations and see if water treatment is required. Because if it is and you don't do it, if you don't install the filtration system, the anti-scale device, or the water softener, you are liable to void your warranty almost immediately. So think about that. So now I'm going to give you a couple of tips. First of all, if you're looking at your ROI immediately on your initial tankless water heater, remember, once you've done all this work one time, the next time you should just be able to change out that tankless. Not near as expensive, because all the other stuff doesn't have to be done. So that ROI actually extends for the life of the house. Because as long as you're putting a tankless water heater in, that's going to help keep you in lower gas bills. Are they going to be that much lower? I've heard good and bad. Is the ROI 10 to 15 to 20 years worth it? That's a calculation for you to figure out. Now, some people, they just want to use more hot water. I had a gentleman call me one time wanting me to install two big tankless water heaters just for his master shower. He had 11 heads running about 2 gallons each. Guys, two massive tankless water heaters just for the shower. That's kind of an overkill. Now, you want to learn how to save money? Two big tips and tricks here. Number one, get the blankets for your tank top water heater. That will help increase the efficiency rating of it, because the water is going to stay hot longer. Also, insulate your pipes coming off your water heater going all the way to the wall wherever they go out at. What this does is it helps keep that heat from escaping at the very top. Another tip and trick to really save money, instead of going a tankless, if you're going to do a tank top, remember, buy a higher efficiency model. Spend a little bit more money. Get a better water heater. That's going to save you money, and you're not going to have near as much investment as you would with a tankless. Now, do I think tankless water heaters are worth it? In the right situation, yes. If you walk in and you go through all these things, most of them are done. The gas line is probably the most expensive, but most of these things are good enough, and you're in a one-story house or an attic to where you're not having to go through a whole floor to redo the vent pipe, it could be a good deal. I looked at it at my house because I wanted to go tankless. I'm in a two-story house and I have a chase that my vent pipe goes through. It wasn't a good fit for me. And guys, I'm a plumber and it still wasn't a good fit. If you've converted from a tank type to a tankless water heater, do me a favor, leave me a comment down below and let me know, was it a good installation? Was the ROI worth it? And how much extra did you have to pay? I really don't think plumbers are doing this just to charge you more money for the labor. It takes a lot more work in order to do this and to do it right. Hope you've enjoyed this. I'm Roger Wakefield, Lead AP, the Expert Plumber. I'll see you in the next video if you don't get flushed.